Hello friends, I Ramesh is going to explain to you the first chapter of social studies, the two big states. In this chapter we are going to learn about the two big states of ancient India, that is Kanauj and Vatapi. In this video I will share with you about Kanauj and its powerful king Harshvardhana. Earlier Vardhana dynasty used to rule on Thaneshwar, that is present Punjab and Haryana. Harshvardhan's father's name was Prabhakar Vardhan and mother's name was Yashomati. His elder brother's name was Rajyavardhan and his sister's name was Rajyashri. Harshvardhan was an Indian emperor who ruled North India from 606 to 647 CE. Actually, he belonged to Pushyabhuti dynasty. After the death of Prabhakar Vardhan due to illness, his mother committed sati, that is, burn alive on husband's body. So his elder brother Rajyavardhan ascended to the throne of Thaneshwar. Harsha's sister married to Grahavarman, the king of Kanauj, that is present Uttar Pradesh. The king of Grahavarman was killed by the king of Malwa, Devgupt, and he imprisoned Harsha's sister Rajyashri. On the other hand, Rajyavardhan, his elder brother, was killed by the god king Shashank. Under these circumstances, the leaders of the kingdom advised Harsha to become the king of Thaneshwar. As soon as Harshvardhan came to the throne, he decided to free his imprisoned sister Rajyashri. In the meanwhile, Rajyashri managed to escape from the clutches of Devgupt and hid in the forest of Vindhyachal. Harsha went in search of his sister and with the help of the people living in the forest and a Buddhist hermit Divakar Mitra, he stopped her from committing sati. Since his sister's kingdom, Kanauj, was without any king at that time, so he became the king of Kanauj and later he defeated the Malwa king Devgupt. Harsha had one more revenge to be fulfilled. That is his brother's death. But as he was not economically strong, so he took the help of a king, Bhaskar Varman of Kamrup, that is Assam, and attacked on the god king Shashank and defeated him. Later he defeated Malwa and Saurashtra, but failed to defeat Pulkeshi II, a Chalukyan king of South India. After winning wars for 7 years continuously, his kingdom became one of the largest kingdoms in North India. Harshvardhan was not only a strong king, but also worked very hard for the welfare of his people. Harsha personally supervised the administration of his state by traveling extensively to different parts of the state. He divided his routine into three parts: administration purpose, public welfare, religious activity. He accepted all religion, which is a great quality of a human being. Sometimes he was so working hard in doing this administrative work that sometimes he forgot to eat his meal. He built many rest houses, wells, step wells, lakes, mathas and viharas. He banned animal killing also. Every year he organized a Buddhist religious meet. Every 5 years he organized a religious function at Prayag. It is being said that it is from here that Kumbh Mela was started. There he would donate everything in treasury with open hearts. Sometimes he donated his own jewelry that he wore. You must have heard about the world famous university, Nalanda University. It was Harsha who gave all possible help to Acharya Shailabhadra to make Nalanda a world famous university. Famous chemist Acharya Nagarjuna also belonged to Nalanda University. He proved iron, arsenic and mercury could be used as medicine. We get a lot of information about Harshavardhan from the accounts of a foreign traveler, Yun Sang. Yun Sang was a Chinese traveler who visited India during Harsha's reign. He studied Buddhism at Nalanda University for 5 years. Yun Sang stayed in India for 15 years and visited different places. It is in his book that he has mentioned that the people during Harsha's reign lived a simple, pious and peaceful life based on living by rules of good moral conduct and justice. Cheating and breach of promise was considered sinful. Bhanabhatta was a great Sanskrit poet in the court of Harshavardhan. His famous works were Harshacharita and Kadambari. Harshacharita means biography of Harshavardhan. Harshavardhan himself was a great writer and wrote 3 plays, Naganand, Ratnavali and Priyadarshika. We have come to the end of this video. In the next session, I will explain to you about Vatapi. Thank you.